center at Fort Ord, here is a man whose only worry about the draft is that he stiffens up when he stands in one, Bing Crosby.
Hey, just a minute there, Ken. You don't have to single me out as the only one who's wide open to an attack of rheumatism.
Yeah.
I want to tell you something, boy. Nearly everybody out here in sun-drenched California's turned a little blue lately.
Rich.
A little bit drizzly.
California certainly had a chilly winter.
But really, in this cold weather, Ken, I want to tell you, I've gone the full route in the underwear department.
You mean to say you're wearing long underwear?
In my set, we refer to them as blizzard bloomers.
That's funny. In our group, they're known as tummy ticklers.
Mine tickle all over.
Oh, do you itch?
They itch, I scratch.
I pass. You know, Bing, since you've been honest with me, I think there's a confession I should make.
Oh, Ken, you don't mean
it. Yes, Bing. I'm wearing longies, too.
Oh, well, it's too bad this isn't an air base here. We both could have landed with our flaps down. Oh.
Well, I know it must be awfully chilly where you're living over in Pebble Beach, isn't it?
Is it? Mm. Boy, Bob Hope is my house guest, you know, and every night we've been sleeping with 3 extra quilts on our bed.
On your bed?
Yeah.
Well, for goodness sake, why do you and Bob have to sleep in the same bed?
Kid's afraid to be alone in the dark, you know. I want to tell you something else, and this is really a fact.
What's that?
This is honest. Fellow walks in his sleep, you know, Hope.
Bob?
Yeah.
What makes him walk in his sleep?
Too cheap to take a taxi, I guess.
Well, that sleepwalking is dangerous.
Well, honestly, I think he was just faking.
Think so?
Sure. He was carrying a lantern. And
lantern?
Yeah. See, I live right there on the golf course, Ken. I think he was on a nocturnal hunt for lost golf balls. Picking an old Dunlop out there.
Bob wouldn't
flight.
Do that.
I don't know. When he came back to bed, he felt awful lumpy. And another thing, Ken, I don't like to really condemn a fella before he's caught, you know, red-handed. You
shouldn't do that,
Bob. But I think... I don't want this brooded rub, but I think the only reason he came up to visit me is to nab the silverware and everything else that's loose around the house.
No, Bing, that's a pretty strong statement. You talk as though Bob were a regular burglar.
Well, all I know is he arrived at my place with 4 suitcases, 3 of them empty. What do you think?
What was in the 4th one?
A floor plan of my house. Also a flashlight, a blackjack, a Jim Inn, and a Dick Tracy comic book. I must be carefree. We've got to go on about the impending heist. Get on with the opening selection here, which, according to the paper, is a song called Undecided. John Scott, I'm ready if you are. First you say you do, and then you don't. And then you say you will, and then you won't. You're undecided now, so what are you gonna do? Now you want to play and then it's no. And when you say you stay, that's when you go. You're undecided now, so what are you gonna do? I've been sitting on a fence and it doesn't make much sense, 'cause you keep me in suspense and you know it. Then you promise to return. When you don't, I really burn. Well, I guess I'll never learn, and I show it. If you got a heart and if you're kind, then don't keep us apart, make up your mind. You're undecided now, so what are you gonna do?
I've been sitting on a fence, and it doesn't make much sense, 'cause you keep me in suspense, and you know it. I'm a wiser duck, and you promise to return. When you don't, I really burn. Well, I guess I'll never learn, and I show it.
If you've got a heart and if you're kind, don't keep us apart, make up your mind. You're undecided now, so what are you gonna do?
'Cause first you say you do, and then you say you don't, and then you say you will, and then you say you won't. You're undecided now, so what are you gonna do?
Now, fellas, I'd like to have you all meet one of our loveliest young singing stars. Very beautiful, very talented, Monica Lewis.
Thank you. Thank you, Ben.
Monica, it's really nice that you could come up here tonight. What are you going to sing for us tonight? Strong, healthy young fellas, Monica.
Well, I thought I might do How Am I to Know from the new MGM picture, Pandora and the Flying Dutchman.
Oh, Pandora and the Flying Dutchman, huh? I wonder if he comes in with his flaps up or down. I must...
I don't know.
You don't know about that, huh?
No, but it stars James Mason and Ava Gardner.
Oh, fine. This is a lovely song. Let's have it, huh, Monica?
All right. It's really love that found its way here. Oh, how am I to know? Will it linger on and leave me there? This strange happiness, for oh, how am I to know? Can it be that love has come to stay? Come to stay here. How am I to
That is real sweet, Monica. Wonderful, wonderful. Folks, I'm sure that that you all read of the heroic efforts of Captain Carlson and the loss of the merchant ship, the Flying Enterprise. However, tonight, for this special occasion, we've had the Flying Enterprise raised and we've towed it to Port Ord. And here it is now, Bob Hope. Thank you, Captain Bligh.
Now, Mr. Christian, come down here.
Look who's calling me the Flying Enterprise. I've been towing you for years, Dad.
That's not me dragging behind you there.
And that's not a streetcar named Desire trailing you either.
I may say, though, candidly, it's a joy. It's really sheer heaven having you at Pebble Beach.
All that?
Yes.
And no money, isn't that? Sheer heaven and no money.
Just to have you at Pebble Beach as my house guest.
Well, I may do all right on that deal.
You're telling me, you burglar.
What do you mean, burglar?
I looked in your suitcase. I found a gym in it.
It's just to get into the bathroom. Ran out of nickels.
Now, listen, I'm glad that you came up here before it ordered me.
I am, too.
But I want to tell you one thing, Lard. I'm still sore about the... I'm still sore about the trip up here. That's the last automobile trip I take with you.
Weren't you comfortable?
Comfortable?
Yeah.
How did I know there were going to be seven of us in the front seat? What a sneak you are, putting an ad in the paper that said, "Wealthy philanthropist traveling north wants company on trip for laughs."
Well, what's wrong with that?
He charged us $20 a piece.
I'm still laughing.
And to think I had a reservation on the Continental Trailways bus.
Quit beeping. I bought your lunch on the way up here, didn't I?
Yeah, but I felt so silly sitting there with my pants rolled up so you'd only have to pay for a child's plate.
Well, after lunch, didn't I pick you up and burp you? Huh?
Yeah, but while you had me over your shoulder, you picked my pocket.
Yeah. Beautiful haul I got out of that. 2 Dewey buttons and a lock of Marjorie Maine's hair.
Please, there's some things a gentleman doesn't discuss.
Oh, pardon my gauche briche. I'm sorry, yeah.
I don't have that.
Well, listen, let's talk about Ford Ord. You know, this is where the new inductees...
Gonzaga talk. Gauche briche.
Wait a minute. Woo-hoo! Woo-hoo! Say, this is where the new inductees here at Ford Ord go through basic training. They learn to face all the dangers... Face all the hardships that they might experience under fire.
So that's why they brought your show up here.
No, that's why we got you as guest. It's even.
What?
Sounds like a dead heat, don't it?
But you know, they sure do draft the fellas in a hurry here. Did you see that one guy who's all bent over?
Yeah, what happened to him?
It's not far from the beach.
What?
Well, that's what it says here.
Wait a minute. Go back there. You skipped the page.
Oh, yeah. I thought that was pretty dull for a punchline.
What is that?
Wait a minute. Not far from the beach. Isn't that all?
Wait, we're on page 50?
Oh, yeah.
Do one page at a time.
No, okay. Let's try it again.
Want to try again?
Stick out your tongue so I can wet my thumb. Okay. Thank you.
Let's see now. You do that line about the guys being drafted first.
Okay, I say, you know, they sure do draft the fellas in a hurry here. Did you see that one guy who was all bent over?
Yeah, what happened to him?
Well, he was a plumber and they drafted him before he could get out from under the sink he was fixing. It's not far from the beach. I think I like that better.
That sounds like the kind of a line you'd give me on your show.
At least I don't glue your pages together.
I'll drop in again. We'll glue you together.
You got the horses for it.
But oh, wait, now.
Keep looking. You'll find a beach in there somewhere. But listen, anyway, on the level thing, the Army can lead to a great career. Look at what General Eisenhower has done.
That's right. I understand if they draft him, he's going to run.
Some of the fellas here tried that, but they caught him and brought him back.
I should think the boys would love it here. After all, they have a chance to learn a trade. Why, just a while ago, I saw a fellow out behind the mess hall peeling potatoes.
Peeling potatoes? What kind of a trade is that?
Wonderful. He traded with the guy who was peeling onions. And, you know, recreation facilities are excellent, too. They have ping pong, shuffleboard, and if they feel like it, the fellas can go swimming in the surf.
It's not far from the beach. So that's where the line fits, you little rascal, you. I loved you the first time I said you. Yes, I did.
You really like that line.
I adopted it. I think it needs a home. But I feel right at home here at Ford Ord. You know, I'm making a picture at Paramount called Military Policeman with Marilyn Maxwell.
Oh, what a nice area to police.
You're thinking right. You know, it's not often you find a Maxwell with a Cadillac body.
Tell me.
But it's interesting making a picture about the MPs, Bing. These MPs are some of the roughest, toughest characters you'll ever meet.
Oh, well, that's bad. You're mistaken. That's bad casting. Why, as a group, the military policemen are the kindest, gentlest, most soft-spoken, obliging boys in the Army.
I guess I haven't met them all, huh?
No, MPs are different, Bob, than they used to be. Why, here at Ford Ord, MP stands for Marvelously Pleasant.
That's funny. I always thought it stood for muscles and poison.
You're wrong, Bob. See, I can prove it. I've got a little skit here that we've written. It shows that just how the military police at Ford Ord operate. And I got a gal here that's going to help us out with the skit, too. Monica, come on over here, will you?
Yes, Bing. What is it?
Well, look what he's been hiding in his duffel bag.
Don't you know Monica, Bob? She's going to...
It's not far from the beach.
Now, wait.
Her coastline reminded
you
me.
You look
of that.
Out. Settle down, 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 boy. Listen, she's going to help us with our sketch. Monica, this is Bob Hope.
Oh, I know Bob. I've seen him on television.
Brave girl.
I may do a TV show for the U.S. Rubber Company.
Well, that's fair enough. You've been wearing their girdles for years. You work for them.
At least I don't make my own out of Scotch tape and never leak.
What about the sketch, boy?
Oh, yes, the sketch. Mm-hmm. Pardon us, Monica. Bob, you're going to play a part of a young rookie G.I.
Yes.
Monica is your girlfriend, and I'm a typical military policeman. Shall we, then?
It's not far from the beach. No. I may want to drive.
Music, John.
We now take you to a secluded, wooded side road on the Monterey Peninsula. It's a beautiful, balmy evening, and the stars twinkle down upon a boy and a girl seated in a Jeep.
Isn't this a wonderful night, honey?
Sure is.
You know, all my life I've been saving my kisses for a girl just like you.
And tonight you'd like to lose your life savings, huh?
Yep, I want to shoot the works. Wowie!
Let go of me. What's the matter with you?
Long time no she.
Behave yourself and read that comic book I brought you.
Okay, hold the flashlight. Golly, this is a thriller.
Shall I read it to you?
Yeah, just the print, and I'm good on pictures. Oh, boy. This is the biggest night of my life. Just think, a date with a Salinas girl.
It's a big night for me, too. Just think, a date with a volunteer lettuce picker.
But, Monica, really, I'm crazy about you. I really am. And I want to tell you that I... What's that, a critic?
That's supposed to be a motorcycle. We forgot to bring a sound man up here.
Boy, what a cheap show. How'd I get trapped?
Never mind that. Now, may I see your pass, soldier?
Golly, it's a military policeman.
Oh, please, Mr. MP, sir. Go easy on me. I know this racket, you know. Don't drag me off to the guardhouse. I'm innocent, I tell you. I'm innocent.
Now, don't be afraid, my boy. I'm here to help you.
You are?
Of course.
Oh, then hold this girl. I want to kiss her.
Well, if you two want a neck, I better hop on my motorcycle and plunge off into the darkness.
It's not far to the beach. How'd that line get in there?
Now, young man, I don't want to be a pest or anything, but inasmuch as you're off the post and it's 3 o'clock in the morning, I would like to know if you have a pass.
Pass?
Yes.
Oh, yes, yes. Here's my pass.
Thank you. This is a pass from World War I.
Well, I am a little overdue.
Well, now, don't you let it worry your pretty little head.
I feel like a cad.
You know, I've never ridden on a motorcycle.
Oh, you haven't? Well, come on, I'll take you for a ride right now.
Oh, thank you.
And now, wait a minute.
No, don't interfere. Just hop right up here, miss.
Okay.
Well, good night.
Good night.
Goodbye, Bob.
Monica, come back. You mean everything to me. You can't leave me alone.
Why not?
Well, who's going to hold a flashlight for my comic book?
Monica and I and Bob have a little personalized version here of a current pop ditty. I think you might get a jar out of it. You ready, Monica?
Mm-hmm.
John Scott? Buddy Cole? Go ahead.
Wish I was a bumblebee by heck. Wish I was a bumblebee by heck. If I was a bumblebee by heck, I'd buzz, buzz, buzz round Gregory Peck. I wish I was a bumblebee by heck.
Now, wait a minute. What do you want with Gregory Peck?
Yeah, what are we, chicken liver or something? Won't we do?
Do, but not with me.
Ay-yi-yi.
Hi-ho, fiddly-dee, I want to be a bumblebee.
Hi-ho, fiddly-dee, a bumblebee is what she wants to be.
All right, Bob, it's your turn. Is there anything you'd like to be?
No, I'm content. After all, I'm charming, talented, lovable. Who could ask for anything more?
If I think you'll come up with something.
Okay, but I may have to press a little.
Come on.
I wish I was a lemon custard pie. I wish I was a lemon custard pie. If I was a lemon custard pie, I'd throw myself in Crosby's eye. I wish I was.
That's very clever, Bob.
Did you like it?
Yes. Now I shall get even.
I'll take it easy, Bud. You know my temper and my muscles.
Your muscles?
Sure, on a clear day, I'm often mistaken for Mr. America.
How well I wish I was a muscle man like you. I wish I was a muscle man like you. If I was a muscle man like you, I'd tear a Kleenex right in two. I wish I was a muscle man like you.
Now I've got one.
No, you've had yours. We got to go for the finish.
What a sneak.
Hi-ho, fiddly-dee, this is what we like to be.
Hi-ho, fiddly-dee.
Hi-ho, fiddly-dee.
Hi-ho, fiddly-dee,
that is what we think we'd like to be.
How do you feel about joining in with me and Once Over Lightly on Sound Off?
Well, I thought you asked me over here to do something funny.
I did. Sing.
Just one more chance to prove it's you alone I care for. Each night I say a little prayer for. Just one more chance. Just one more night to taste those kisses that enchant me.
Presents the closer for this evening. Now, my thanks to Monica Lewis, Bob Hope, and all those who joined us here at Fort Ord for this evening's show. We'd like to tell you folks listening that the soldiers here on this post contribute 2,000 pints of blood every month to the Red Cross.
Isn't that wonderful? And you know, the boys here bought over $300,000 worth of bonds in the recent defense bond drive.
And this post has contributed over $50,000 to local charities.
Yes, sir. I want to tell you, this is some outfit. Thanks also now to General McClure, Colonel Solomon, and the special services and all who have been so very nice to us here on our visit.